I look back over 2 decades of my career in market research and consider what's important or what's the number one priority as opposed to what you think it is when you start your career, there's one clear answer to that. It's not statistics, it's not surveys, it's not tools, it's not techniques. It's quite simply people. I don't mean to be trite, it's really an understanding of human beings. And I say that as now an agency owner, I can clearly see that there are two aspects to that answer as well in terms of understanding human beings. It's about selection of those human beings. It's about the blend of those human beings. And I say that from both the perspective of, say, my staff, my company. I think it's quite clear that then if you have a good blend of the right people, you have a good company. But equally, the same answer applies to respondents, the people that supply the food for our industry, the information on which we analyse, interpret and advise. I think if we understand those, all of those people as human beings, interact with them properly and get the right blend, then we can truly be successful. I think that's the big difference in my understanding, because originally, to me, it was all about textbooks, it was about statistical techniques, about how to write the best questionnaire, and I clearly see that as being very different. I don't know whether that's changed in the 20-odd years, but clearly that is the case for me. I think, and again, this may be oversimplistic, but I think where the industry as a whole, and this is the market research industry as a whole, has maybe made errors. I think there are two aspects to this. If we look at where we need to grow the industry, you can talk about growing the industry in terms of volumes. So there's simply more market research undertaken. I think in that case, we have to look at engaging clients. So in other words, proving that what we're delivering, that what we're doing is making a difference. And I think that needs to be done in a commercial sense. I think we have to bear in mind that quality is in the eye of the beholder. And in our case, the beholder is the client. If we've not engaged them, provided something useful and something actionable, then we've failed, regardless of the fact that we may have ticked all the boxes along the way and made ourselves compliant and been happy about that. I think we have to, number one, in terms of volumes, grow the industry through proven objective evidence that what we do makes a big difference and equally engages our clients, again, as human beings. We mustn't forget these are human beings, so they need to be engaged, sometimes even entertained, with what we do and how we deliver it. One of the big learns, you know, big changes in my 20-odd years is that we no longer write 500-page reports. We now deliver 25-page PowerPoints with visuals, photographs, metaphors, anecdotes, and the evidence. It's not just the evidence. There is a flavour that comes with that. That's one answer to your question regards to growing the industry in terms of volumes. I think there's another answer to that question, which is in terms of improving the value. How can we protect our industry and the margins? Let's be again commercial. The margins that our industry as suppliers has to do. We have to protect ourselves. I think we have to look at the history. I think one of the mistakes our industry has made is that we have undermined ourselves. We've made ourselves a commodity. We've produced projects at good value. Of course, if there's high competition, those projects are commoditized, and what happens is the projects get cheaper, the margins get eroded, and then you have a lot of difficulty making money. And it's not just about making money, but that sustains the industry. You know, we'll have a dying industry if there isn't some money to be made, at least. How do we do that? We have to look at other industries and learn from them, perhaps. And I'm thinking here, maybe, you know, some of those that are put on a pedestal are the accounting industries and the legal industries. But let's look at how they've protected themselves. You know, they all work collectively to protect what they do and value what they do. And I stress the word collectively. And I think that is where the MRS perhaps can play a role going forward, is to draw us all together as providers and buyers of market research to work collectively, to not just protect it, but also to grow it. And that is through the proven evidence that it works, but also by putting a value on that and protecting that value and not seeking to undermine that value and removing the commoditisation of our industry that has occurred, certainly ever more in the last 20 years. In conclusion, the world as a whole is moving from an information society to a creative society. And I think the market research industry as a whole has to appreciate that and move with those times. We're moving away from percentages and bar charts to entertaining visual multimedia presentations. And I would conclude that the MRS has to appreciate that as much as anyone and build that into codes of conduct.